الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل وسلم على عبدك وحبيبك ونبيك ورسولك سيدنا محمد. ما شاء الله، I'm very proud that I see ما شاء الله all this ما شاء الله majority of them are youth just come to listen for something about Quran. So may Allah تبارك وتعالى make this gathering إن شاء الله in the sake of Him. May Allah تبارك وتعالى make all His angels descend to our gathering and give us sakina in this majlis inshallah. Let me ask you a question first. How many companions mention in Quran? If you know the answer, just raise your hand. Yes, one, only one. What's his name? Zayd. How many of disbelievers, kuffar Quraysh, who attend the revelation like Abu Jahl and all this stuff mentioned in Quran? How many? No one? One. What's his name? Abu Lahab. So just one companion, Zayd, and one disbeliever who attend the revelation, Abu Lahab, and that's it. However, we have many names: Qarun, Fir'aun, Haman, Harut, Marut, Talut, Jalut. All this name which is long time ago. We love the companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why didn't Allah don't mention the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman, Ali, Sa'ad, Sa'id. Just one, Zayd. And even Zayd, Allah mentioned him for purpose. And even in Zayd, in Arabic language, if you don't know the name, specific name of someone, you can call him Zayd. I met Zayd min al-Nas, just anyone. But Zayd, Allah mentioned him because this is, he want to clarify a concept in this Quran, which is adapting child. Abu Lahab is the only one. Not Abu Jahl, not Rabi'a, not Shayba, not Al-Walid, not any one of them, just Abu Lahab. And where did Allah mention Abu Lahab? Where is Surah Al-Masad in Quran? In the beginning? In the end? What's the surah before Surah Tabbat Yada? Ah, I can't hear you. Did you have lunch today? Are you sure? Okay, Surah An-Nasr, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ. Surah An-Nasr is the last surah revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In Hajjatul Wada', in the third day of Yawm Al-Eid, in Masjid Al-Khayfi Bimina. The last surah revealed to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. However, تَبَّتْ يَدَا from the beginning. Why the last surah, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ, with surah of the beginning, تَبَّتْ يَدَا, together in the end of the Mus'haf? And why Allah mentioned Abu Lahab? We all know that Abu Lahab is the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has 12 uncles. 8 of them die before prophethood, and just 4 of them attend the prophethood. 8 die before: Al-Harith, Al-Zubayr, Al-Muqawwim, Abdu Ka'ba, Dirar, Qutham, Al-Mughira, Al-Ghaydaq. All of them die. Just 4 attend the prophethood: Abu Lahab, Abu Talib, Hamza, and Al-Abbas. So Abu Lahab, his own uncle, he mentioned these two surahs together to tell us, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ. This religion, Allah will spread this religion every single corner in the earth. Whoever stand against this religion, he will be like Abu Lahab. تَبَّتْ يَدَا أَبِي لَهَب. Abu Lahab one day stand in front against this religion and say to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, تَبَّ لَكْ أَلِهَذَا جَمَعْتَنَا. Now we read in the end of the Quran, إِذَا جَاءَ نَصْرُ اللَّهِ وَالْفَتْحِ وَرَأَيْتَ النَّاسِ. And you saw people come to religion. Look, we gather
in a mosque in London. Deen is spread everywhere. Nobody can stop this deen. And we have example for that, Abu Lahab. Another thing is the uncle of the Prophet ﷺ. It means this deen, it just depends to your heart. If Allah open your heart, you will become Muslim. And if Allah doesn't want to open your heart, Abu Lahab is the own uncle of the Prophet ﷺ. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala open our hearts to his deen. So as we said, just one companion and one disbeliever, Abu Lahab, but many old names. Why I ask you this question? To tell you, Quran is not for Sahaba, just for Sahaba. If Quran is just for the companions, then he will mention many names, many places in Medina. But Quran is for everyone, in everywhere, in every time. So he didn't mention the names of those who attend the prophethood. However, he mentioned Fir'aun, Haman, Qarun. Why? Because all these names, it's not just specific people. And this is key if you want to reflect upon Quran. Any name in Quran is just an example, just a character. It's just a personality. Allah wants to summarize one personality in Fir'aun, for example. Fir'aun is not just a Fir'aun with Musa, no. Fir'aun every time. That's why when Allah mentioned Fir'aun, he described him in details. That's why when Abu Jahl died, in which battle Abu Jahl killed? Uhud, a strong Badr. So Badr, how many disbelievers killed in Badr? 70, good. So Abu Jahl killed in Badr. Prophet ﷺ said, مات فرعون هذه الأمة. The Fir'aun of this Ummah was killed in this battle. Fir'aun. Fir'aun is not a person. Fir'aun can be any time. So the old names, it's just examples. That's why Allah mentioned Fir'aun, Haman, Qarun, As-Sahara before they became Muslim, Junud. This is examples. Fir'aun is an example of the ruler when he want to make all the slaves of Allah just slave for him. This is the feature of Fir'aun. أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. And every Fir'aun has a Haman, has Haman. Haman is that person who has authority after the ruler, and you always do whatever the ruler say. يَا هَامَانُ ابْنِ لِي صَرْحًا لَعَلِّي أَبْلُغُ الْأَسْبَابِ. Every Fir'aun has a Qarun. Qarun is a businessman. Maybe he was from the layman, from the normal people. كان من قوم موسى. He was from among the people of Musa. However, because the money, he just care about money. So he go with Fir'aun because he's afraid about his business. Sahara. Before they became Muslim, Fir'aun called them. When? The duty of Sahara is just to make sihr of the public, to change the truth. It's like in our days, kind of media, if you want to make a general concept and make this very spread for people, go to the media. It's like sihr nowadays. It can change the mind of many people. So Fir'aun, Qarun, Haman, just examples. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala want us to reflect upon this Quran. No names attend the prophethood. to just reflect. Second, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam, we don't have tafsir, full tafsir of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam to Quran. We have many tafasir. Why we don't have full tafsir of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam? He is the best human being when we come to tafsir al-Quran. But we don't have full tafsir of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam. We just have few ayat. Again, why? Why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wa sallam didn't make tafsir of the whole Quran one ayah by one ayah? Because this Quran is for everyone. If Prophet ﷺ give us the tafsir of Quran, the companions, they will not understand. Why? Because they will not understand till the time go pass, and we will discover a lot of things in this universe. Then we will read some ayat and said, oh, now we understand. Because Quran is for us also. So every generation, they will understand something the previous generation, they will not understand. That's the miracle of this Quran. So that's why Prophet ﷺ didn't give tafsir, full tafsir of Quran. Because you may ask, but Quran is in Arabic language and everyone knows Arabic, can have tafsir of full Quran. No. What does tadabbur mean? أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. تدبر come from the end of anything. It means if you want to understand this ayah, it's not about words. Words is just the first level. There's something deeper. And the more you recite Quran, the more you will get. The more you'll get that meaning. The more you will involve in this dunya, the more you will understand Quran. That's tadabbur. So, in this tadabbur, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala want us to reflect upon Quran. When I mention this ayah, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ, this statement is just two times in Quran. Who can tell me which surahs? Go on. Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Good, that's number one, yes? Surah Al-Nisa, very good. So just two places. Surah Al-Nisa, in this, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. نساء. In Surah Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ, same statement, but the end is different. أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Why two times? That's another key of reflection. If Allah mentioned the ayah just in two places, so look deep at these two places. There's something I want to tell you in those two ayahs. First place in Surah Al-Nisa, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ, why they don't reflect upon Quran? وَلَوْ كَانَ مِنْ عِنْدِ غَيْرِ اللَّهِ لَوَجَدُوا فِيهِ اخْتِلَافًا كَثِيرًا. If this Quran is from someone else, you will find a lot of contradictions. But because it's from Allah, you will never find. Go and search. Search whatever you want. You will never find any contradiction. So in this ayah, he challenged your intellect, your mind. Go and make search. The second ayah in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he challenged you in another aspect. He said, أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. Why you don't reflect upon Quran? Because there is locks upon your hearts. Here he didn't challenge your intellect, but challenge your heart. He said, You can't reflect because you block your heart. It means if your heart is sound, Allah will open your heart to understand Quran. It means those people who commit a lot of sins, then they come and recite Quran. Why? Some people, they reflect, they crying, they can understand a lot, they focus on their salah, but I can't. Maybe because there's a lock. You should remove that lock. Come to your Lord and try to repent to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Then He will open your heart. So that's two places just to encourage us to reflect upon Quran. If non-Muslim, your friend or your colleague at university, in college, ask you a question. What's the longest surah in your book? Everyone know it. Suratul Baqarah. What does Baqarah mean? The cow. If he asks you, the longest surah in your book called The Cow, why? Why the longest surah is not the Furqan? Is not about some theme seems very important. Submission. Why the longest surah is just The Cow? And to surprise you more, the story of the cow, just one page. Baqarah, 48 pages in Mus'haf al-Madina. The story of the cow, just one page. One page. But the whole surah, the Prophet ﷺ called the whole surah the cow. That's another key of tadabbur, of reflection. If Prophet ﷺ named the surah, the name of the surah is a secret to reflect upon surah. But just you have to look deeper. You all know the story that some of Banu Israel, Musa told them, "Inna Allah ya'murukum an tadbahu baqara." Atattakhiduna huzwa? You make joke of us? What's the age of that cow? Is it small, old? Okay, what's the color of that cow? Tell us more about cow, some silly questions. And eventually, they sacrifice the cow. Surah Al-Baqarah have the main themes in Quran. Surah Al-Baqarah has the first story, Adam, the most important story. Surah Al-Baqarah has long passage about Banu Israel, then building the Kaaba, Ibrahim and Ismail, then changing the Qibla. Then after that, you have the main rules, Salah, Zakah, Siyam, which only in Baqarah, Hajj. Then you have a long passage of the rules of family in Quran. Then a long passage about the financial transactions in Quran. It's a main themes. Why Prophet ﷺ called the surah the cow? For that small story. Because that's the way that Quran wants you to reflect. When you heard the cow, straight away you will remember the story. Straight away, the cow, it means the story of Banu Israel. Okay, I remember now the story. Then, that story summarizes the main fault that the people of the book before us commit this fault. So Allah told us in the beginning of the Quran, after Fatiha, wait. How you will receive this revelation? It's more important to go with all the rules of Quran. More important to obey is how you receive the revelation. This is the most important question. That's why it's in the beginning of the Quran. The Banu Israel, how they receive the revelation, is like the story of the cow. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ. If Allah is something huge, big in their heart, the Muslim, whatever he heard, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ. Oh Allah, thank you that you give me this honor to receive your revelation. Oh Allah, I appreciate that you talk to me. Who am I? We are nothing in this universe. Allah honor us to talk to human being. How honor is this? So when Allah sent us revelation, we should appreciate. We should fly out of joy. But those people, أَتَتَّخِذُنَا هُزُوًا, you make fun of us, Musa. Okay, tell your Lord, أُدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّكَ. Did you hear this? قَالُوا أُدْعُ لَنَا. They didn't say أُدْعُ لَنَا رَبَّنَا, our Lord. They say أُدْعُ لَنَا, call us your Lord. Look at this disrespectful. It means they don't have this honor, this respect to their Lord. So that's the most important thing. Before you continue in reciting Quran, stop. How you will receive the revelation. Like Banu Israel or like Ibrahim. Straight away in Surah Al-Baqarah, after Banu Israel, the story of Ibrahim and building Kaaba. Ibrahim, when he built Kaaba, he said, Rabbana, he make dua for us. For the last ummah. Oh Allah, send among the last ummah a messenger. And this messenger will recite ayatul kitab, yatlu alayhim ayatik, ويعلمهم الكتاب والحكمة ويزكيهم. Then Ibrahim said, إذ قال له ربه أسلم. قال أسلمت لرب العالمين. That's the key of Surah Al-Baqarah. أسلمت, I submit. Not make joke of revelation. Oh Allah, I submit. It means I'm your slave. Whatever you said, I'm ready. Not just that. وَوَصَّى بِهَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ بَنِيهِ وَيَعْقُوبُ. He conveyed this message to his children. And look at Yaqub before he died. Imagine someone, this is the last word of Yaqub. إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِي قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَائِكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا وَنَحْنُ لَهُ مُسْلِمُونَ. Before he died, he makes sure that his children same the method of Ibrahim. مُسْلِمُونَ. Muslimun, it means when you receive revelation, you feel excited. Who am I that Allah care about me to give me permission to mention His name? Who am I that Allah care about me that He give me permission to listen to His words? That's big honor. So I should, oh Allah, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. That's word which is summarized Surah Al-Baqarah. Banu Israel, in the same surah said, سَمِعْنَا وَعَصَيْنَا. We hear, but we disobey. Muslims, Muslim, who submit. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. That's why in the end of the surah, آمَنَ الرَّسُولُ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ رَبِّهِ. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam encouraged us to recite these two ayat every single night, because these two ayat summarize the main point of Surah Al-Baqarah. Don't be like the people of the cow. Be like Ibrahim, aslim. If you take this, then the rest of Surah Al-Baqarah, Hajj, Siyam, Salah, Zakah, the rules of family, transactions, all of this, you will receive anything because you have the key. سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. Last thing in Surah Al-Baqarah, we can divide it to two passages. First one is Banu Israel and their faults. The second one is the old rules. Between these two passages, we have three pages about turning the Qibla. Qibla before was towards where? Manchester? Jerusalem was Aqsa. Allah turned Qibla to Mecca. Again, tadabbur is a deep meaning. It's not about turning Qibla from place to place. It's about turning the leadership from Banu Israel till this Ummah. That's the deep meaning. To turn the leadership, no more Banu Israel, the leaders. Now the leader is this Ummah, which is the center in Mecca. So we are the leaders of humanity if we submit to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And it's come in the middle. How many ayat Surah Al-Baqarah? How many verses in Al-Baqarah? 286. Who is good in math? No one. Divide 286, divide 2, 143. Very good. Ayah number 143 is تحويل القبلة وكذلك جعلناكم أمة وسطا. وسط in Arabic has two meanings, the middle and the best. This ayah is in the middle exactly, 143. And it's about قبلة. It means Baqarah can divide it to two passages. Turning the leadership from Banu Israel. Why? Because the story of the cow. To this Ummah, which is their slogan is سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. That's just small example of tadabbur. Look how Quran is. Look at the sweetness of Quran. If you read the whole surah of Quran is like this, then you will be in another world. In another world, believe me. We have how many surahs we have in Quran? 114. Okay. Among this 114, there is one surah, just one. The name of this surah is one of the names of Quran. Which surah? Kon. MashaAllah. Surah Al-Furqan. Surah wa? Al-Furqan. When Allah chose the surah to be the name of Quran, He chose Furqan. Not Quran. Not Surah Al-Kitab. Surah Al-Furqan. Furqan is to make distinguish between truth and false. That's the Furqan. Umar Al-Faruq. Furqan is distinguished, clear distinguish between haqq and batil. Why Allah called Quran Furqan and chose this name? That's another key of tadabbur. If you want to have taste the sweetness of Quran, you should stop and ask yourself, why I recite Quran? What's my main intention? Some people, they recite Quran just to get reward. Alif, lam, mim. Ama inni la aqulu alif, lam, mim, harf. Walakin alifun harf, walamun harf, wa mimun harf. They said one letter equal 10 good deeds. And we have more than 300,000 letters. 300,000 letters times 10. Mathematics, more than 3 million. So some people, they just have this calculation. Oh, if I did one khatma, I will have 3 million. Bismillah, this Ramadan. 3 million, 6 million, 9 million. It's not like that. Don't count your good deeds. Never. You can count your bad deeds. That will help you. But never count your good deeds. Do you know why? Very simple. Because one of heart diseases, spiritual diseases, can remove all these good deeds. If you have hasad or arrogance, all these heart diseases, they can remove your hasana. Don't count it. But why then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us about this? Good question. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just to encourage us to read. But when you read and reflect, wallahi, you will forget about calculation. You will enter another world. You will spend in Surah Al-Fatiha 7 days, just reflection. So all this ahadith just to encourage us, because we don't know the sweetness. For example, if your children, your child, he doesn't know the meaning of something, only adults know this meaning. Okay, come, I will give you these sweets. I will give you this chocolate. When he tastes this, he will forget about the chocolate. He just finds something amazing. Prophet ﷺ also encouraged us to recite. But when you recite and reflect, La ilaha illallah, you'll find something amazing, completely amazing. So first, don't recite just for reward and calculate that. Some people, they recite for barakah. And absolutely, Quran is kitabun mubarak. But the problem is, they define barakah in very limited way. Barakah is in everything, but barakah, in their opinion, it's what? It's just, I will put mushaf in my car, then I will not have accident. That's barakah. Barakah I will put in that shelf in my house, then my children will protect from jinn. That's barakah. Very limit. So they recite Quran just for this. Bismillah, the open mushaf. Allah will protect me from all accident or tickets and fines. All of this. So this is barakah. Some people, they recite Quran when they feel that they need tranquility, they need sakina. They commit a lot of sins. They involve a lot in materialism. So I need sakina. And they come to Quran, that's amazing. That's why when they come to Quran and recite just one page, they're crying. Because they feel they're far away. That's amazing. But the problem is, when they feel that sakina, they close the book and they say goodbye. After several months, they will come again. The key intention of Quran is to read Quran as a furqan. Distinguish between haqq and batil. To read Quran as a huda, guidance. To read Quran as a nur, light. To read Quran as a maw'idha, reminder. Allah combine all of this.
Ya ayyuhan nasu qad ja'atkum maw'idhatun min rabbikum wa shifa'un lima fis sudur. Shifa'. La ilaha illallah. This is medicine for our heart. We need this medicine. وَشِفَاءٌ لِمَا فِي الصُّدُورِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ.
If you read Quran as a furqan, as a nur, as a guidance, then look at that the big difference now. If you read Quran for just reward, you recite quickly because you just need reward. If you read Quran just for barakah with the limit definition, then you recite for half an hour and that's it. But if you recite Quran and your intention is to as a guidance, as a distinguisher, then you will stop in every single ayah. Why? Because you want to know the meaning. How can you get the guidance while you don't know the meaning? So when you recite, you will stop. In the beginning of the Baqarah, أو كصيب. Oh, what's the meaning of صيب? You will ask then. You'll have this curiosity. Because how you will get the guidance from some words you don't know the meaning? That's the big difference. That's why you will reflect. And from this day, from this amazing mosque, and many mashallah youth, I will encourage you, if you take the golden advice today, take this. Learn Arabic language. Wallahi, if you listen and watch millions of videos about translations, about explanation, you never get that sweetness if you don't know Arabic in deep way. Parents, if you need your children to get this flavor of Quran, teach them Arabic. Now, alhamdulillah, there is many centers, many online. Arabic is not a language of specific race. Arabic is a language of the book of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. And for those people who are Arab, anyone here speak Arabic? Naturally, can you raise your hand, please? Okay, mashallah. For those people, if you speak with your children or your young sisters or brothers in English at home, you did something dangerous, believe me. You cut the relationship between them and Quran. Allah gave you this ni'mah that you speak Arabic naturally and you speak with your children or siblings in English. Subhanallah. So please don't speak with them at home in English. So if you learn Arabic, that's the key. It's a difficult, yes, but it's worth it. Long journey, yes, but worth it. So if you read Quran as a furqan, then you will ask questions. Why many muhadarat and lectures, when any lecturer came to the mosque, and he allowed people to ask 10 minutes after lecture, we'll find this type of questions. First of all, I have a waswas in wudu. That's common. Second, I have a problem with my wife. Third, what's your opinion about mortgage? That's the main questions. But you never find, it's very rare, that a question come to the lecture, what's the meaning of this ayah? I've read a lot of tafaseer, but I find some deep meaning in this. Is that correct or not? Why there's no questions? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala encourage us to reflect. If you read Quran as a furqan, you'll have a lot of questions. You'll have a lot of notebooks when you read Quran. Because Allah encourage you. Sometimes the ayah end with Alimun Hakim. Sometimes Hakimun Alim. Why? Just to let you question. Why in this specific place? Just to reflect. For example, Suratul Anfal. It's about what? Anybody can tell me? What's the theme of Surah Al-Anfal? Yes. Go on. Huh? What? No, but it's about a specific battle. Badr, very good. It's about Ghazwat Badr, the battle of Badr. If you read the battle of Badr in Kutub al-Sira and the battle of Badr in Surah Al-Anfal, huge difference. That's the amazing of the Quran. And in Surah Al-Anfal, Allah mentioned one ayah twice, one statement. As I said, this is the key of reflection. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّا. Only in Surah Al-Anfal. And two times. أُولَٰئِكَ, those are the truly believers. The truly believers, just two times in Quran. In one surah. Surah Al-Anfal. In the beginning and in the end. Why? Because Surah Al-Anfal summarizes the factors of victory. If this ummah need nasr, it's just two factors. اتقوا الله وأصلحوا ذات بينكم. Have a good connection with Allah and a good connection with your brothers, Muslims. And all the surah just explain these two things. For the first thing, the relationship with Allah Ta'ala, he said, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ حَقَّا. إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. الذين يقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا. True believers, because they have a good connection. When the ayat of Allah, they feel something in their heart amazing. So if we have a good connection with Allah, second thing, good connection with Muslims. The problem of many Muslims now, they don't have victory, that conflict between Muslims. Allah said in the same surah, وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ. Allah made the heart of the Sahaba combine each other. Look, Ansar and Muhajirin. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وهاجروا وجاهدوا في سبيل الله والذين آووا ونصروا أولئك هم المؤمنون حقا. When Ansar and Muhajirin come together, then the victory come. When we feel that I'm from Mauritania and my brother from Pakistan, my brother from Libya, my brother from America, I feel this brotherhood, then the victory will come. But if we just look, shaitan come between us, divide us for the race, color, nationality, groups. So look, very concise, because it's Quran. Because when Quran says something very concise and very deep. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala encourage us to conflict upon Quran. And the main thing is Arabic. I will tell you something about Arabic, just to give you why Allah Tabarakata had chosen Arabic language to be the language of the last book, which is the book for all humanity. Torah is not in Arabic. Injil is not in Arabic, but Torah is for specific people. Injil for specific people. But Quran is for all the humanity, different colors, different languages. Why choose Arabic? Because Arabic is very deep language. Some examples. In Surah Yusuf, when he saw the dream, he say, Inni ra'aytu ahada ashara kawkaban. Inni wa ra'aytu. This is past form, verb here in past form, ra'aytu. But we have three other dreams. The dream of the king and the two dreams of the prisoners. These three dreams, قال أحدهما إني أراني not رأيت أراني أعصر خمرا وقال الآخر إني أراني وقال الملك إني أرى. The three in present form, not in past form. Why? In Arabic, if you say in present form, it means they repeat. They saw this dream more than once. King and this true prisoner, they don't see it once. No. They keep seeing this dream, then they ask about. But Yusuf was a child. Just once, إِنِّي رَأَيْتُ أَحَدَ عَشَرَ كَوْكَبًا. Just verb. When Yusuf meet his brother after more than 20 years, أَوَى إِلَيْهِ أَخَاهُ قَالَ إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ. If you know Arabic very well, this tarkib is not normal at all. He would say, إِنِّي أَخُوكَ, that's it. Or, أَنَا أَخُوكَ. But, إِنِّي أَنَا أَخُوكَ is unusual. Why unusual here? Just to express the emotion in that situation. Yusuf was Aziz Misr, prime minister. And this, they thought he was dying. This brother, he can't imagine that this is Yusuf. So he said, Inni, indeed, I am, again. Inni, ana, I am the one who in front of you, wallahi, I'm your brother. Very concise and just to express the emotion. Because this is the Arabic. The same expression in the end of the story. قَالُوا أَإِنَّكَ لَأَنْتَ يُوسُف. Unusual expression. Just to express the emotion. In Arabic, for example, we have walidain and abawain. Walidain is parents. Abawain, parents. But in some specific places, Allah said abawain only, like Surah Yusuf. But in some specific places, awalidain. And this is purpose, for purpose. Because abawain is ab and When you heard abawain, father here is the main character. But walidain, walida, mother is the main character. Are you with me? Abawain, who is the main character? Father. Walidain, mother. Whatever Allah encourage us to respect our parents, He will use walidain. He never use abawain. It means your mother is first. Wabil walidaini ihsana. He will never say wabil abawaini ihsana. It means your mother first. And any dua in Quran, always walidain. Rabbi ighfirli wa li walidayya, not li abawayya. Mother first. However, in Surah Yusuf, wa rafa'a abawayhi. Because who's the main character in Surah Yusuf? Yaqub, the father. Or in inheritance, wa li abawayhi li kulli wahidin minhum as-sudus. Because father take more than mother. Look at this Arabic language. Very concise. If you have that knowledge, then when you recite Quran, you're just flying. When I was very young, when I was 22 years old, I studied Arabic with my father. In Mauritania, they focus on Arabic too much. Memorize thousands of poetry just to be expert in Arabic. Then, when I heard Quran, I just feel I'm in another world. And when someone recites in front of me or I pray behind someone, I say a word in our local language. If I'm very excited, I say aski. Aski, it means wow. So I used to say it unconsciously. So I went to one Darul Ulum, we call it Mahadir in Mauritania. one big scholar of Muhammad Salim ibn Addud, one of the big scholars of Mauritania. He died 2009. I study 1 year there. So in the first year, I'm behind him. His qira'ah, not that nice voice like now youngs, but you can understand everything from that qira'ah. You're not that type of qira'ah. So I'm very interesting. Every ayah, ski. So my neighbor, he make like this. Ski. Then when I finish salah, he hold me like this. Come. You joke and play during salah. And we went to the sheikh. This young man is crazy. He always ski. The sheikh look at me. Come here. Why you say ski? I say, because I feel I'm in another world. It just, what do you understand from that ayah? I said, this, what do you understand? He said to me, that's amazing. Allah give you ni'mah. However, don't say ski anymore. So, I mean, if you feel that Arabic language in that level, it's just la ilaha illallah. It's just something you can't translate it to any language. You just feel it. You can't translate it. So my message to you today, if you just can taste that flavor, you will find the best ni'mah in this world. Ni'mah that you feel the words of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. You will feel them that, subhanallah, you will live in another world. Especially if you have a long qiyam after Shaykhuna Abdul Rashid Sufi. I was an imam and khatib in Qatar. And in the first year I came them, before I become imam, I spent the whole Ramadan with Shaykh Abdul Rashid Sufi. Big masjid, full of people. Qiyam start from night number one, not from Ashr al-Awakhir. Switch off the whole light, darkness. 3 hours and a half. You are in just flying with no ski. Flying. Say, subhanallah. So if you don't know the meaning and you pray behind Sheikh Abdul Rashid, you'll have sweetness because you know that this is the words of Allah. Absolutely. You will cry. Allah will give you something. However, you will not feel that in that level before you study Arabic. So youngsters here, please, if you can study Arabic, please go ahead. Believe me, you will never regret. You will never regret, insha'Allah ta'ala. So the tadabbur al-Quran, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala encourage us to reflect upon Quran. I gave you one example of Surah Al-Baqarah. And there's many examples which I took one surah and go around it, and you'll find something amazing when you connect the name of the surah with the whole surah. For example, Surah Al-Furqan. We just talk about Surah Al-Furqan. In the end of Surah Al-Furqan, after immediately the sajda, Allah talk about عباد الرحمن. Is that right? وعباد الرحمن الذين يمشون على الأرض هونا وإذا خاطبهم الجاهلون قالوا سلاما والذين يبيتون لربهم سجدا وقياما والذين يقولون ربنا اصرف عنا عذاب جهنم إن عذابها كان غراما إنها ساءت مستقرا ومقاما. Till the end of the surah, عباد الرحمن. In the end of Surah Al-Furqan, the point here is, Al-Furqan should look for some people who study Furqan, act upon Quran, their life is just an example of al-Furqan. Like Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Ummuna Aisha said, كان خلقه القرآن sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When some tabi'een ask Aisha radiallahu anha, tell me about the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, did you recite Quran? Just any good character in Quran, that's the character of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, al-Furqan, look for Ibadur Rahman. Where is Ibadur Rahman? So don't just recite Quran, that's not enough. Or memorize it, or more important than recitation, more important than memorization is to act upon Quran, to be Ibadur Rahman. When anybody look at you, that's from Ibadur Rahman. Quran affect you. And in this surah, in the middle, Surah Al-Furqan, Prophet ﷺ raised a complaint to his Lord.
وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا.
Oh Allah, this ummah, they don't care about Quran. My nation, they don't care about Quran. What does that mean? It means this is the words of Allah. And still some Muslims, they can't read Quran properly and they don't even try.
La ilaha illallah.
Hada min hajri al-Quran. If you can't read Quran properly and you don't even try, this is musiba. We should say to you, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Musiba. Some people, they can't, that's okay because they try. But if you don't try, it means you don't appreciate that you have this treasure in this earth, the words of Allah. Many WhatsApp groups now, Zoom, they just want some people dedicate their time to teach people how to recite. Second level is to try to recite it every single day. Many Muslims, they make khatma after maybe 1 year in khatma. Subhanallah. Allah gave us this treasure. And we spend 1 year, we don't complete Quran. More level than that, to try to memorize some. Ikhwani, in the day of judgment, if you memorize and act upon what you memorize, you'll have this amazing situation. O Abdi, Iqra wartaqi. Read and I will raise you every single ayah one level in Jannah. It's not about memorization only. Memorization itself with no acting can lead you to Nar Jahannam. Wallahi. Some people, they can memorize Quran and go to hellfire. That's not from me. From the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Sahih Muslim, أَوَّلُ مَن تُسَعَّرُ بِهِمُ النَّارُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَ قَارِ. The first one, Allah will put them in hellfire, is a qari. Why? He just want fame. I recite that people know me. I have a podcast. I am very famous. That's not for the sake of Allah. So, in this surah, Allah, Prophet ﷺ complained about Hajrul Qur'an. We want to come in the day of judgment, that Prophet ﷺ was very proud of us. How? Try to how to recite Qur'an properly, then make a habit to recite it every day, then try to memorize some of Qur'an, third, try to know the meaning of Qur'an, five, which is the most important, try to act upon Quran. Act upon Quran. And try to teach that Quran to your siblings, your children, your any. If we do this, then we'll be among Ibadur Rahman fi Suratil Furqan. May Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala give us this ability to reflect upon Quran. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to find the sweetness of ayatullah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They, in 2 minutes, if you give me permission, I will speak in Arabic, give a sweetness for those who understand Arabic. Raise your hand. Oh, very few. Then the rest will be very angry. Okay, I will try to make it in English. I will try. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in 2 ayat in Surah Yunus and Al-An'am. وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ اللَّهُ بِضُرٍّ فَلَا كَاشِفَ لَهُ إِلَّا هُوَ. Same beginning ayah in Yunus, but different end. Okay, in Al-An'am. If you have any difficulties, only Allah can remove that difficulties. وَإِنْ يَمْسَسْكَ بِخَيْرٍ. If He relieve that difficulty and give you khayr, فهو على كل شيء قدير. Allah can do anything. Question here is, after that, He said, وهو القاهر فوق عباده. He has a dominant over all His servants. Why He mentioned this ayah here? Because I understand now He can do everything for me, but He suddenly mentioned He has control over all His slaves. Why? Because when you have difficulties and Allah remove it and He give you khair, when you listen, oh, Allah will give me khair, you said, but what about that boss who prevent me from promotion? What about that rule which prevent me to get that thing? What about those people who always against me? You always think about the barriers of people. Allah said, وَهُوَ الْقَاهِرُ فَوْقَ عِبَادِهِ. Ya miskeen, they all slaves. If Allah give you this, nobody can prevent you from that. Then you will ask, then why He don't give me then? وهو الحكيم الخبير. He will give you, but He is حكيم. He is a wise. He will give you in the time He wants, not in the time you want, because He is the wise, the حكيم. يونس. وإن يمسسك الله بضر فلا كاشف له إلا هو. Same. وَإِنْ يُرِدْكَ بِخَيْرٍ فَلَا رَادَّ لِفَضْلِهِ. If He يُرِدْكَ, if He want خير for you, specifically for you. Why for you? Because He has some people, يُصِيبُ بِهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. He choose some people specifically to give them something amazing. Then you said, it's not me. I know myself. I always commit a lot of sins. Absolutely, I am not among those people. Then He said, end the ayah with, وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. This ayah, when I read it first time, long time ago, I said, why غَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ here? Because He said He can do whatever you want. I expect that He will say, وَهُوَ الْكَرِيمُ, the most generous, وَهُوَ الْفَتَّاحُ, وَهُوَ الْقَدِيرُ. However, وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ, why in this place? Because when you heard this, that for specific people, you would say, not me, not me. I know my sins. He said, وَهُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He forgive you and have mercy upon you and give you whatever you want. May Allah تبارك وتعالى give us this inshallah ta'ala. والله أعلم, صلى الله على عبده ورسوله سيدنا محمد.